While Min Woo was eating his chicken nuggets, I was actually studying science, and I found that open market operations are similar to movements of your body, in the same way that movements of your body parts are the key means by which your thoughts are executed. Open market operations are the key means by which monetary policy is executed. Now, you all know that the Fed has three tools to implement monetary policy: the discount window, the required reserve ratio, and open market operations. Now, in this presentation, I hope to show you that open market operations are the most important monetary policy tool at the Fed's disposal. Now, in what you'll see in this presentation is that open OMOs are flexible and they're very frequently used. So in this presentation, I'm going to explain monetary policy and FOMC's role in this, the types of OMOs, there are two types, the trading desk at the New York Fed and how it implements the OMOs, and the big picture, what is the impact of OMOs and why they're important. So now on to the FOMC. As you know, the FOMC meets many times over the course of the year, to be precise, 8 times, and then they can have emergency meetings as they did in October. And at these meetings, the FOMC decides the Fed funds rate and whether they want to change it. And this is a target for the Fed funds rate. It then shifts responsibility to the manager of the system open market account, SOMA. And this manager heads the trading desk at the New York Fed. And all the nitty-gritty work is done by the staff at the trading desk. So before we go into what the staff at the trading desk does, you need to understand the types of open market operations. Now, as your economics teacher have told you, as Steph has just told you, and as I will tell you right now, open market operations are the trading, are the buying or selling of securities by the Fed. And this impacts the total reserves in the Federal Reserve System. Now, there are two types of OMOs. The first is outright purchases and sales. Now, in this, the Fed buys or sells securities, but this is a permanent transaction. It's a long-term transaction. And so oftentimes, if the Fed is buying the security, it's called, this part of the portfolio is called buy and hold. It will hold the security until it fully matures. And then if all the profits from that security will be reinvested. Now, the second part of the portfolio is the repos. And the repurchase agreements are transactions in which the Fed will make a loan to a primary dealer who will then deposit the check into his bank. Now, the tricky thing here is the bank will then give back to the Fed securities as collateral. So this is basically a collateralized loan. Now, the repurchase part of this is that the primary dealer agrees to repurchase that security and pay back the money with interest to the Fed over a short period of time, usually from 1 to 14 days. Now, reverse repos are just the opposite. The Fed is the borrower here, and the primary dealer is the one, is the lender. Now, back to the open market desk. In order to know what open market operations need to be done every day, the trading desk, the staff of the trading desk, come to work at 8 a.m. and for 2 hours analyze the reserves in the market at that time. Now, before I go into this, you should know that there are three things that the staff needs to look at in order to estimate the total reserves and how these reserves will change over the day. The first thing is obviously the required reserves. That can change based on how many deposits are made during the day. The second thing is the percent of excess reserves that are not lent. Now, usually this is very small. However, recently many banks are keeping their excess reserves, and this has made it very difficult for the staff to estimate it, estimate how much will be kept. And third is the discount window, the amount that banks will borrow from the discount window. And again, this is usually very small because it is seen as a sign of weakness to shareholders if the bank lends from the discount window. So based on all of this, the Fed, then the staff at the trading desk, creates a reserve path. So it needs to know exactly what it has to do to the reserves to keep the Fed funds rate at the target level. So it has to adjust the reserves. And it estimates the reserves, the amount of reserves that need to be in the system to keep the Fed funds rate at the target level. And then it needs to estimate how it needs to change the reserves to move it to the target level. So you'll see more in the following slide, or the slide after this. But how does this actually work? Well, you should know that first, what we're talking about here are repos. The daily operations of the trading desk are usually repurchase agreements and reverse repurchase agreements, because these allow for the fine-tuning of the reserves. They're short-term. So what the staff creates a plan every morning, and then the manager of the staff calls the director of monetary policy affairs, I believe, the director of division of monetary policy, and needs to get that plan approved. And then the transactions actually occur on an online website called FedTrade. Now, the Fed is trading with a certain number of dealers. And these primary dealers need to be approved by the Securities and Exchange Commission. And this is all just to make sure that the Fed is not making risky transactions, to minimize risk. And then what happens is, let's say the Fed wants to make the loan and buy a security. Well, it'll have a 10 to 15 minute silent auction on the website in which the dealers make offers. And the Fed selects the best deal for it. So if it's making a loan, it wants the highest interest rate. And so there is no favorites in this. And now the impact of these transactions is the Fed is changing the reserves. And so what happens is a change in the reserves causes a change in the Fed funds rate, and this indirectly leads to a change in short-term interest rates. Now, I'm not going to go into this, but I'm sure you've learned in macroeconomics how exactly this works. So let's quickly look at an example. Here we have the Fed funds market, and in this case, the Fed is expecting unemployment checks to go out. So they expect an increase in the supply of reserves, because as people deposit their unemployment checks, banks have more reserves. So then the supply has shifted right. So the Fed then, the staff, knows that it needs to decrease the supply, so it will use reverse repos. It will take out reserve from the system. And so what happens is the supply shifts left, and then since banks have less reserves, there is a greater demand for reserves to meet the required reserve ratio. And so demand shifts right. So just as an overview, the open market operations are very important for the daily adjustments of the Federal Reserves. And they're flexible because they allow for the fine-tuning, and they're effective because they actually change the reserves, and they allow the Fed to control the Fed funds rate.
Okay. There you go.